Tell you what, boy, he come in there real early on me this morning. I really wasn't expecting him any movement that early. But I think I shot him about 7:45. And he's a big-bodied deer, big old spike. He wanted to be a three-point, but neck swollen and everything. Man, I'm tickled to get him. I'm having a slow season, and it's picked up. I killed one yesterday afternoon, and now I've killed this one this morning. This makes three for the year. The deer's moving pretty good right now. This joker, I was set up in this branch right here. I came in here, I think it was Thursday morning, and checked it, and there was a few water oaks up in there that were feeding pretty good, a lot of good sign on them, and I climbed in there Thursday afternoon and didn't see anything, and I had to go back home. I've been over here camping for 3 or 4 days, and I done run out of clothes, and I had to go home and wash some clothes and restock on my food supply. But I came back in here this morning, it's Saturday, and climbed. And when I walked up to the bottom of the tree, I was standing there with my headlight on, just fixing to go up. There was a deer probably within 25 yards of the tree out behind me in the pines right there that ran off. And I hate to bump one like that, but ain't nothing you can do, you know. But it wasn't, like I said, it was probably 7:45. I looked up, and you know, you hadn't had enough light to shoot but for maybe 30 minutes. And seen this joker coming, and I could tell right away it was a big-bodied deer. I couldn't see the antlers, and anyway, I got stood up and got bow in my hand and got the camera running. And I was expecting him to come straight up through the middle of this little branch arm that I'm sitting on. And he didn't. He kind of veered off and like he was going to cut behind my stand. And I got the camera around there, but I had the camera attached to the right side like I always do, but to video back around this side, I had to swing that arm around, and it's starting to get crowded right there for me making a shot. And he got there where he did, and I had a pretty good angle. He was quartering to me just a hair, and but I, you know, real quick looked at it and I said, I don't think that's too bad. I think I can slide it right in there. And I had him in the camera good, and I went ahead And Drew, if I'd have waited, let him come on a little bit further, maybe give me a little bit more of a flat broadside angle, I was going to be in a position where that camera was just, if I was going to get any video at a shot, the camera was just going to be all in my way. So I went ahead and shot him, and I hadn't rolled him over yet to see where it went in. I'm thinking I probably went through the edge of the shoulder blade going in, and that's why I didn't shoot all the way through him. You can see the broadhead sticking out right there. It didn't quite come completely through, but it's, well, actually it did. There's the back ear of the blade sticking through the hide right there. But he whirled and ran, right up out of the branch right here, and I caught a couple of glimpses of him out here in the pines. And right about where I'd glimpsed him last, I heard a huge crash and then nothing else, and I knew he was down. But I'm tickled to get this jerker. He's a, this makes buck kill 121. This makes number 3 for the year. It's number 30 from old Centaur right here. And this makes number 73 with traditional equipment. And like I said, man, I'm proud to get this jerker. It was looking like there for a while we was gonna be eating a lot of beef this coming year. But freezer's starting to look a little different now. I'm gonna field quarter this jerker and get him out of here. I don't have really too far to go. Maybe all the way back to where I'm parked at, it ain't a half a mile. Probably more like 600 yards, something like that. I'm going to knock the hide off of this jerker, and we're going to get out of here, and I might do a little scout and see if I can't find something else to climb on to see.